welcome to my chicken, to my kitchen. Welcome to my kitchen. And today we're teaching SS how to cook chicken adobo.
Here's what you need. You need 3 cloves of garlic. You need 1 regular onion. If you like onion, then just use a bigger one or use 2 regular ones. Here's the soy sauce. And vinegar. Alright, so of course chicken. I'm gonna buy chicken in a bit. Those are the main items that you need. And usually Filipinos would add hard-boiled eggs, so we're gonna boil these later. And potatoes. But I don't like potatoes, so I'm not adding potatoes. Some Filipinos would add sugar, so I don't do that. I just add the oyster sauce to make it sweet. I'm gonna go buy the chicken, and I'll be back with you in a bit. Alright, so now we're boiling the water for the egg, and I'm just gonna go shower because I was outside. See ya! Okay, let's start this. Let's heat up the pan. Alright, keep it a bit of oil. Or butter, if that's what you prefer. Okay, so SS with adobo, you can actually put anything you want, except the ingredients that will alter the taste. Like, there are ingredients that would enhance the taste of the adobo, and there are ingredients that would change the taste of the adobo. So one of those ingredients that you're not supposed to put would be tomatoes. So no tomatoes. I'm gonna put a little butter. You can put the garlic in now. You don't really need to toast it so much, you need to put it in there for a bit. Also, I put too much oil, so just a drop will do. Then, once that's doing that, you can add the onion. The onions are kind of glassy now, so I can put the chicken. So you brown it for a bit. So some people, they want the chicken to be fall off the bone tender. So what they do is, they boil it first. They boil it in water and salt, and sometimes a little bit of ginger. But we're not doing that right now. I'm just showing you like the basic adobo. Right, so we're browning it. And the meat in adobo could be pork or chicken. There's no beef adobo. But you can also do vegetable adobo. Like, you can do eggplant adobo, and it's the same process. Just garlic, onion, soy, vinegar. That's it.
I think the eggs are good.
Yeah. So, the eggs just need to be hard boiled. So these are good to go. You just have to remove it. And then put it in cold water. So I put it in cold water. And then I'm going to put a little ice on that. So that later you won't have any problem removing the eggshells. Some people also say they need to put salt so that the shell will be removed easy. But yeah, the ice works for me, so no more salt. If you want to do that, then you can. And then tell me if it works. I think at this point this is too much ice. But, you know, so what? Once they're brown, you can add the soy and vinegar. So what I do is, I just make sure the soy covers the chicken. I cover the chicken with 2 tablespoons of soy. I'll put 2 tablespoons of vinegar as well. So the thing about vinegar is you shouldn't mix it until it's already boiling. I guess it is boiling now. But we're gonna put a little water on that. Put drinking water, of course, not tap water. Alright. I don't cover the meat, but if you like more sauce, you can put more water. Alright, so this is pretty much done. This is adobo. You got the garlic, the onion, the chicken, the soy, and the vinegar. And this is adobo. And anything you put after that is just your choice. So, no tomatoes, again. If you really love onions, you can put it after the dish is already cooked. Usually what other Filipinos do is they add potatoes and eggs. So we have the egg. For my kind of adobo, we will add oyster sauce. I'll give you an example of what a different type of adobo looks like. So this is the adobo I cooked yesterday. Yes, I cooked yesterday and didn't film, so I can't show you that. But I put okra and carrots, and there's potatoes right there. The chicken is underneath all that. So you can do that, and that will be all up to you. Sometimes I put cauliflower, but they don't have that right now, so. And one more thing. So we have a Filipino failsafe, and it's called Magic Setup. So I'm not endorsing this or whatever, but if you taste your adobo and it doesn't taste good, then you did something wrong. And what you need to do is just put this and it will make it right. Now, I'm not gonna put this because, actually, let's go taste my adobo. It is cooked already. It's just that the chicken is not yet cooked. But the outside is cooked, so I'm gonna take it. It is so sweet. So sweet.
What makes it really sweet is the oyster sauce. You just need to put more water when it's salty, when it's too sweet. Or you can just put magic setup. And it can make everything better. So I usually cook it for 40 minutes, and we're not past that yet. So let me just cover this first, and I'm just gonna have coffee. Watch it, Essays. Don't let it burn. Let it burn, let it burn. Ah, ow. Alright, breakfast of champions! Yes, I'm eating two eggs. So, that's your basic adobo, SS, because you're a basic that's your basic adobo. So, I'm gonna eat, and I'm gonna turn this off because, yeah, it's not that kind of video.